What is a product? How is it related to projects and operations? You might know these things, but do you know what's the difference between a product lifecycle and a project lifecycle? Let's figure it out. Hey, this is Praveen Malik from PMbyPM.com, your ultimate resource for the PMP exam prep. I have made it my mission to help you pass the PMP exam in your first try. Today, I'm going to talk about what is a product, how is it related to projects and operations, how projects and operations overlap with each other. Stay tuned till the end of this video and I'll tell you what's the difference between product lifecycle and project lifecycle. Before we go ahead, please subscribe to this channel and click on bell icon. This way, whenever I release a new informative video, you'll get an instant notification. So what is a product? As the definition goes, any input to or output from a project is called a product. Now, this is a very simplistic definition. Let's look at the output part. So project creates a product which is handed over to the operation. What does this mean? Let's look at an example. The example of a car. Project will create a car. I'm not talking about the manufacturing of the car, the initial design and prototype. So initially a car is designed and prototyped. In fact, multiple prototypes are made. These prototypes are tested and finally a prototype is chosen for the production. This prototype is handed over to the production department. They produce the car, they manufacture the car, and then the customer come and buy the car. Customer drive the car and then they come back to the company for the regular maintenance. So here you will notice a project created a new car and then operations took over for production and maintenance. Projects are unique and temporary, whereas operations are ongoing and repetitive. To understand what's the difference between projects and operations, you can click on the card above to look at my earlier video. Let's understand what is product lifecycle. A product lifecycle is a series of phases that represent the evolution of a product from concept to delivery, growth, maturity, and to retirement. The keyword here is evolution of a product. What does this mean? Let's understand what is product lifecycle. Let's look at this diagram. So you have an X and Y axis. On X axis, there is time, and on Y axis, there is effort. Effort by the project team. Initially, a product is conceptualized and a project is started. At the end of the project, a product is created. And this product is handed over to the operations. The operations maintain it for a long period of time. And then somewhere down the line, another project is initiated to upgrade the first product and a version 2 is produced. But the operations keep on going. They go on and on and on till the end of the product. That is when the product is retired. So in case of a car, project 1 would produce first model, then it will be operationalized. And then after some times, maybe 3 or 4 years, another model will be introduced in the market. And then the operations will take over and then it will go on and on and on till the car is retired. So how does project and operations work together? So projects are represented by a blue line and operations are represented by a green line. At the end of a project, the product is ready, but the operations are not ready to take it over. So project team hands over the product to the operations. And operations take the knowledge base, understand the product and start their work. So there's a small overlap between projects and operations at the end of a project. Each time a new project is introduced and the product is upgraded, there's a small overlap between projects and operations. Alfa Romeo Spider. It was one of the most popular cars of last century. But how is it related to project management? We just talked about product lifecycle. So consider Alfa Romeo Spider as one of the products. Now it would have been conceptualized somewhere in 1960s. They started manufacturing in 1966 and the last production batch was in 1993. Now for about 2 decades, they manufactured this car. But in these 2 decades, there were a series of cars. In fact, there were four series. And in each series, there were many models. So each model was conceptualized and a project was initiated. And then that model was handed over to the production. So Alfa Romeo followed a complete product life cycle from 1966 to 1993, when the car was finally retired. So was the product life cycle from 1966 to 1993? No, it was not. The product life cycle would have started with the first project. And the first project would have started somewhere in early 1960s. So much before 1966. So what is a project life cycle? A project life cycle is a collection of phases. And each phase has five process groups. So what does this mean? So you can click on the above card to understand what is project life cycle and process groups. So how is it different from product life cycle? At the end of project life cycle, a product is produced, which is handed over to the operations. The product life cycle is collection of multiple projects and ongoing operations. A project life cycle is limited. That is, it can last for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. But a product life cycle could be potentially unending. It can go on and on and on till the product is retired. And when is it retired? Nobody knows. Only the market can tell when the product has to be retired. So tell me, when does the product life cycle of a car ends? Does it end when the company stops manufacturing the car? Or does it end when the company stops servicing the car in its workshop? I'm curious to know. Please comment below. Thank you for watching this video. You can follow me on Quora, LinkedIn, and Facebook. You can find the links in the description below. Before you go, like and share this video and subscribe to this channel.